Hi YouTube. MidJourney has just added 3 new features to play with. It's not enough that they left their competition in dust with version 5, but they just keep adding things, increasing the technology gap between themselves and their competitors. Stable Diffusion. Let's take a look at these new features and how to use them. The first new feature is the describe command, and this is similar to the clip interrogator on Stable Diffusion, which tells you what prompt might have been used to create this particular image that you're uploading. There are countless tools like this already on Hugging Face, but the difference between those tools and this one is that this one's specific to MidJourney, so you might get a lot better results using this. The use of this tool is very similar to the blend command, but instead of typing slash blend, you're going to type in slash describe, and then you're going to upload the image in there that you want to describe. So this is the first image that I want to describe, so I uploaded it and now I'm just going to press enter. So it gives you 4 options here of what it thinks it's looking at, and you can click on any of these to try and recreate it. And so let's click on, let's say, the 4th one here. And so you would just go down here where it's 1, 2, 3, 4, click on it and it'll throw it into the prompt, or actually put it right here and you click on submit. And let's see what it gives us. All right, while we're waiting for that, let's go take a look at the actual picture in my gallery and see what I put in here to get this picture. So right here it says a woman. Let me see here. So it used much different words than I use. They don't look the same at all, but let's see if it creates similar results. So it kind of got the style down with the background and everything of the feeling of the photo, but it didn't get the picture itself. But just like the clip interrogator, it's not perfect. You got to actually add your own stuff in there to kind of narrow it down to what you think it is and combine that with what it gives you to get a good prompt or try to get the picture that you're trying to achieve. I made a couple more examples putting some of the style elements I used originally, and this is what I came up with. So some of them, the color is different, and you got to remember too, that was a version 4 prompt, but I think it's just the describe feature isn't as descriptive as it needs to be. But you can see here that some of the weird elements, this alien like stuff, is coming over. But this was probably a hard one for the describe feature, so we'll try another one right after this. But even if you had the exact same prompt, which I did, you could put it back in there and it won't give you the same result anyway. So that's something you also have to keep in mind. I did a couple more examples, and this one was with version 4 with the same describe feature stuff. And this one was with the new Niji 5, and Niji 5 is amazing. I mean, you look at the detail in here, it's pretty amazing. Like this one in the top left, even actually all of them, I love all of them. The bottom one here on the left, quadrant 3, and one in the top right, they all look pretty amazing. Here's another Niji 5 one, and it's pretty amazing. Look at this one in the bottom right. That's a pretty cool character. Let's try one more picture. So I'm going to type in slash describe, press tab once, then you get the box, and then go ahead and drag in your image. All right, so let's, I got an anime one, so this one should be a lot easier. All right, so it was just the first picture. It had way too much going on, and this one had much better results. And so if you see here, it's a girl running in a field of flowers during golden hour, and the flowers are all different colors. And I put Studio Ghibli to get that particular kind of anime art style. Let's look at what the describe feature gave us. So the first one right here, it looks pretty good. I mean, the colors aren't exactly the same. It's not as golden hour as it should be, but it's still pretty relevant and pretty similar to the original image. So let's take a look at the next one, and it's getting even better. Too much detail on the girl, but it's still, we got the colorful field of flowers and we have the golden hour and the girl's running. So let's take a look at the next one. Same thing, but the girl's not running. And then the last one is very similar. So this one is probably the most similar out of the 4, but it's definitely in the right direction. I think if I use Niji 5 or Studio Ghibli, it'll be even better. By the way, if you didn't know, to use the new Niji feature, you can actually go into settings, and then you could just click on Niji version 5 in here. You could put dash dash Niji version 5, but if you always have it set to MidJourney version 5, it's going to add dash dash V5 at the end of your prompt as well. So I don't know what that does to the picture, if it combines the two, but it's going to be in your prompt. So just keep that in mind. All right, let's take a look at the next command. And for the next command, you actually need to have it in fast time. So it's the repeat command. So if you type in dash dash repeat and you put a number after putting a space between the word repeat, it will run that prompt as many times as you want. Actually, 10 is the max for the standard version and 40 is the max for the pro. And you also have to be in fast mode. So I'm in relaxed mode now. So I'm going to show you what happens. I'm going to try to repeat it twice. And it's going to ask me if I want to do this. It's going to do it 2 times. I'm going to say yes, and it's going to say job restricted. So just type in slash fast, enter, and then do the same thing. So dash dash repeat space 2, and say yes. Now it says two of your jobs are running, and that is the repeat command. Pretty simple. I don't know how useful it is for a normal user, but if you had a business and you were making like hundreds of pictures, then I would see getting a lot of use from this. Let's take a look at what the repeat to command gave us. Okay, so repeat executed my prompt twice, and here's what I have, and I used Niji version 5. So this is the picture that I described earlier, the anime picture of the girl running in flowers, and it did it in Niji version 5, and it looks pretty nice. So that's a pretty simple feature, but I don't know how like useful it is for most people. But there is a feature that's similar but is very useful, and it's if you ever use XYZ plots in Stable Diffusion, is exactly like that, but you have a different formula to run it. So let me show you that right now, and that is the permutation command. The first thing to take note of permutations is that you have to do it in fast mode, so it's going to create a lot of images, and that's actually going to waste you a lot of GPU time, so just keep that in mind. But the max you can do at once in a permutation is 10, and if you got the pro plan it's 40, and basic users can't use it. Sorry, I know it sucks, but I think they might change that in the future. It seems like they're aiming to do that. But if you take a look at the prompt now, you'll see Joe Biden in a, and then you have curly brackets around bio, nano, steam, cyber, goth, diesel, cloud, and those are all separated by commas. So those are all going to be pretty much like multiplied by the other one in curly brackets, which is punk. So you're going to have biopunk, nanopunk, steampunk, cyberpunk, goth punk, diesel punk, cloud punk, and then cinematic theme setting. So that's pretty useful. And if you've ever worked in Stable Diffusion, it's similar to X and Y plots. So it's just a different formula, right? So let's try this out. So I'm going to press enter, and you're going to see it's going to ask you if you want to create 7 different prompts. And I'm going to say yes. Actually, I'm going to say show prompts first. And here you can see all the prompts that it's going to create from this particular setting. So if you put something else, like if you look at where punk is, if you put comma and then another keyword, it's going to multiply all of that again by that second keyword. So this is going to be twice as long, but you can't do 14 using the standard version. You can only max out at 10, but you get the idea, right? You would have to do like 5 of these and 2 of these, which will equal 10 total. So let's try this out. I'm going to click on yes. And as you can see, it's starting to populate all of them. And also, you know, the standard version has like a queue time after 3, I think. And I think the pros like doubled, I'm not sure, but definitely want to keep that in mind. All right, so let's take a look at the results. And if you didn't know, version 5 actually brought back celebrities. So that's something to take note of as well in version 5. And all right, so the first one is the nanopunk. So this one doesn't make sense. I mean, I guess it's kind of nano. There's computers in the background, but okay. The next one is the biopunk one. So this one doesn't really follow biopunk, but I guess that has nothing to do with the permutation. It did do the biopunk. So next is steampunk. And yep, that's steampunk. Not as much steampunk as I would like. The next one is diesel punk. That's not really diesel punk, but it did put the diesel punk in there. One thing you could take note of too is that if you put a space between the curly brackets, it'll actually separate like nano and punk or diesel and punk. So if you wanted the word separated, you can do that. So for example, the curly brackets that had all the different bio, nano, and all that stuff, and versus the other one that had the punk in it, you can put a space in between that and it'll come out with a space. And here's cyberpunk. Yep, that's cyberpunk for sure. And then goth punk. Nice. All right, so the last one was cloud punk. Not the best pictures, but it actually did what it was intended to do, which is pretty much multiply everything by punk to get cloud punk, goth punk, biopunk, and all that stuff. So that's basically what permutations are now. And you can experiment by putting more keywords in the brackets, but remember, you're limited to 10. It has to be on your fast hours, and you can only do it in the standard and pro plan right now. Another way you could have done it is by just putting something like strong female NA and just one curly brackets. And I have atomic punk, steampunk, biopunk, cloud punk. So now it's going to execute all of these, but it's not going to multiply it by anything. So I'm going to press enter. I'm going to show you what this does. And then it's going to ask me if I want to make 4 prompts. And you could see here that what it does is basically just kind of took the normal prompt and combined it with each of these in here. So I think that's the simplest way you can use a permutation, and probably the way most people will probably use it, right? All right, that's all I want to show you guys for now with these 3 new features, but I'm going to leave a little outro video because I made a lot of pictures for this tutorial and they look pretty sick. So I'm going to just kind of let them play for the outro. And if you liked the video or if you learned something, don't forget to leave a like, and thanks for watching.